Bernie has a bachelor's degree in electronics engineering technology and a master's in ministry degree. He's been working in the computer industry since 1984. After 25 years as a born-again evangelical Christian, he became an atheist in 2009. He participates in many Christian atheist debates, which can be found on his YouTube channel, which I think is called Secumar.
Secumar, yeah, short for Secular Humanism, S-E-C-H-U-M-M-E-R.
He's the author of a booklet called Modern Science and Philosophy Destroy Christian Theology. He is also involved in local humanist groups and is a certified humanist celebrant. On a monthly basis, he visits the humanist group in the Sheridan Federal Prison to give them support. So we'll start with two 10-minute presentations.
Okay. This is actually a picture of a protest here outside of a Hooters. I think it's in San Francisco. The woman's holding a sign, "Women are not decorations." I'm gonna come back to this. But you know what, in our society, there's a dialogue about what is appropriate attire and behavior for women. So that's one thing I'm gonna address also. So let me start with, since we're talking about feminism here, what is the F word? What is feminism? And so here's a real easy definition I'm going to give. It's the advocacy of women's rights on the grounds of political, social, and economic equality to men. So in other words, treating women like men. And as far as I'm concerned, if you think that women should be treated like men, then you're a feminist. You could be a guy feminist, you could be a woman feminist, it doesn't matter. As long as you believe in equal rights, you're a feminist. That's what it means. So. If somebody says, "I believe in equal rights, but I'm not a feminist," I would have an issue with them. I would say maybe they don't understand what the word is, and I'm going to talk a little bit about that also. So, for example, here's a question just to think about the word a little bit. I think it's a fact that women seem to be underrepresented in math and physics. They're not underrepresented in everything. For example, from what I understand, for veterinarians, it's heavily dominated by women. So there's some fields, and even I think there's more women in college than men. Some fields, there's plenty of women, but in math and physics, there seems to be an underrepresentation. So maybe there's two possibilities. Maybe women are culturally dissuaded from going into math and physics, or could it be that women naturally aren't as interested in math and physics? Which one of those sides would be a feminist viewpoint? Well, I think the answer is neither one, actually. I think this is it's something that feminists can debate. And actually, there is a good debate on YouTube. One of my role models is Steven Pinker. I think he's one of the most brilliant guys alive. He's like the Einstein of philosophy and just about everything, I think. I learned a lot from him. And he debated this woman named Elizabeth Spelke. And they talked about this very thing. And they're both feminists. So this is something where somebody could take a side and say, "Well, I'm a feminist and I believe this," but that doesn't mean they're speaking for all feminists. So what I want to introduce to you is that you can be a feminist and disagree with other feminists. There's like factions in feminism, just like there's factions in Christianity and atheism or anything. You have the extreme sides and you have things that people can argue about. Here's another example. Look at these bathing suits. There's for women. I mean, one woman might say, like, "Oh, women should not dress so scantily like that. They should wear a one piece." And then here's a picture of it, just to be equal. Here's a guy. It has what they call a banana sling, I think, or something. He's basically nude almost. And somebody else has board shorts. So what's the correct feminist position? I think feminism is about equal rights. These guys have the right to wear what they want to wear. So I don't think this is a feminist issue. I think it's a social issue. So I don't think you should say there's a feminist position on this. Here's another one. I'm trying to show two extremes and a center point. Again, with women attire, what could they wear? On the right hand, there's a woman wearing body paint. She's basically nude. She might be able to go out in public like that. She may get away with that. I don't know if she would get a ticket for that. Because in a way, she's kind of covered up. On the other side, we have women wearing bags. They're basically the burqa, and then in between there's like a dress that would be perfectly acceptable, like a 50s kind of look. So I think the woman on the right wearing the body paint She's got equal rights. She could probably get away with that. I think that's a social issue. I don't think that's a feminist issue, whether she should be able to do that in public or not. The ones in the burqa, though, this might be something that's interesting to debate, because some women might say, hey, they're making a choice. They want to wear that. They should be allowed to do that. And there may be a counterpoint saying, well, you know, they're prisoners of their religion. They don't understand that, you know, it's like a Stockholm syndrome. They don't realize their minds have been captive. They don't know what it's like to be equal. They should be liberated from this. The burqa should be illegal. So, you know, I could see how people would debate that. Personally, I would go on the side where I think they should be liberated. They should be told there's a different way, but you got to realize you're talking to a brainwashed person, a person who's saturated in this system where it's normal to them. So, you know, you just can't go in there and say, it's difficult to go into another country and say your whole system is crazy, you know. So this is part of the clash of the civilizations, I guess, with the Muslims, because they have a whole totally different way of living. So the first question was, we have two questions, and the first question was, does Christianity harm women? I would say yes and no. I would say yes, most denominations do have harmful ideas about women, but I would say no, not all denominations. So I think me and Karen would have a disagreement here. I think she is saying all Christianity is harmful for women, and I would say no, I don't think so. So here's some more details on that. For example, one way most Christianity has a problem with women is, especially if you're a Protestant, I mean, women are forbidden from leadership in a lot of positions. They can't be the head of their church. And if you look at the Catholic Church, for example, I'll just go to the next slide. The Catholic Church, for example, in America is 21%, I believe in America is 21% of all Christians are Catholic, and so by far it's the largest denomination. And in this denomination, you have a pope, and there's no way you're gonna have a woman pope, according to the current system. And then they have their priests and their nuns, and a woman cannot ever be a priest. So, and I think the priests have, they're higher up in influence and prestige than a nun, for example, too. So that's an obvious example of problems with women equality in the largest denomination. And then I've been to Baptist churches where, of course, like I said, you can't have women leaders. But I think it's important to recognize how people self-identify, and if somebody says they're a Christian, we have to appreciate that. When I was a Christian, in my final state as a Christian, I didn't have any problem with women. I thought it was perfectly fine for women to be in leadership. So in my brand of Christianity, there was no problem with feminism. I would totally support women for any position, total equal rights. So that's my disagreement with Karen. I would say not all Christians today. So here's a passage. You know, actually, people argue you can use the Bible to prove either way. I mean, for example, in 1 Timothy it says, I do not permit a woman to teach or to assume authority over a man. She must be quiet. But if you go to the website for the Four Square Church, a church that was started by a woman, Amy Semple McPherson, you go to their website and it says, empowering leadership culture. It says, according to God's gifting and calling, we will intentionally prepare and release men and women across generations and cultures into all positions of leadership and areas of ministry. So as far as I used to attend a Four Square Church too. As far as I know, they have absolutely no issues with women in any kind of leadership position. And it makes sense because their whole church denomination is started by a woman, so how could they have a limitation on it? So now I'm going to talk a little bit about the new atheism movement. There's two cases, and Karen didn't bring up either one of them, but one of them is called Elevator Gate, and this is where a woman activist basically at a conference, it was 4 a.m, she's going back to her hotel room, and a guy said, hey, I really like what you said. Would you like to come to my room and we can talk about it some more over some coffee? And she basically said, guys, don't do that. That's a bad thing. And then Richard Dawkins, who's the most famous atheist, said basically, oh, because Rebecca Watson was kind of sounding like, you know, this is some kind of, I don't know, some feminist issue or something. And Richard Dawkins was saying, oh, you know, poor you, you know, like there's women suffering in all these other cultures, you know, under Islam, and but you know, poor little you got invited to coffee at 4 a.m. in an elevator. I feel sorry for you, you know. So some people said, you know, Richard Dawkins is really bad, and that's a, you know, misogynist, woman-hating kind of attitude. So that's one issue, and I don't think that's a feminist issue. I think that's just a social etiquette issue. The other one is Michael Shermer is a very famous atheist, and he was accused of date raping a woman, and that was all about gossip, I think. There was nothing there. So I'm out of time, but I do have a slide here about all the great things that feminism has brought us. So I just want to say, in summary, I think Christianity does have some built-in problems with feminism, thanks to the Bible. But in atheism, the new atheism movement, I would say there's no problems whatsoever. So that's contrary to Karen's position. She thinks there's a problem in the new atheism movement, and I say there's no problem whatsoever. So.
Okay, thanks, Bernie.